Kenosha's Common Council just voted on an emergency declaration that gives the mayor new temporary powers.
Let's go straight to Tom Durian with what those new powers mean for the city leader. He joins us live now from Kenosha.
Yeah, Shannon and Steve, that declaration will go into effect as soon as the prosecutor announces his decision, which is expected within the next week and a half, but could come as early as tomorrow. Then it would be in effect for 8 days unless the mayor asks the council for some more time. In Monday's virtual Common Council meeting, alders voted to give Kenosha Mayor John Unteramian the authority to declare an emergency in the city after prosecutors released their decision on whether or not to charge the officer who shot Jacob Blake 7 times. While the mayor made clear he does not know what the decision will be, the hope is to avoid scenes like this from August when unrest and violence spread through the streets.
Everybody has a right to a peaceful protest, but it is our council's and the city's responsibility for safety for all people.
Alders questioned the widespread notion that demonstrators would be kept in specific areas. The mayor said this declaration wouldn't give him that authority.
There is no designation being done to anyone as to where they can and cannot go.
The mayor will have the authority to close streets, parks, and other city facilities and issue a curfew. Around the city, businesses that weren't already boarded up since the summer have been busy covering windows.
We're preparing for the worst and hoping for the best.
Barricades have gone up around town, blocking streets and diverting vehicle traffic away from the downtown area and Civic Center Park. Just as in the summer, Governor Tony Evers has activated the National Guard at the request of the city. 500 troops will be sent to Kenosha to assist law enforcement and protect government buildings. The ACLU of Wisconsin urged the city to be conscious of the protesters' rights in the days ahead, claiming they violated them in August, saying in part, "We hope that the Common Council recognizes Kenosha's deeply flawed response to past protests and works to develop an approach that respects people's constitutional rights." Now, also approved at tonight's Common Council meeting, a hike in the city's disorderly conduct fine that will go from $124 to $1,321. That is the type of charge someone would receive if they broke any of those emergency orders. Reporting live in Kenosha, Tom Durian, TMJ4 News.
All right, Tom, thank you.